is my new Kelly kettle, and I'm trying out to see how it works, how it can boil 0.75 liters or about, what, 12 ounces of water. Using just a few sticks and stuff. You see how this bark burns, birch bark burns pretty good. See if this thing will go in there. Regular bark isn't so great, but when you're out in the bush, you probably have to use anything you can get your hands on. So I thought I would sort of mimic that. I'm just using scraps from the garage. Scraps that I had gathered for kindling in the house. Hope that I can spare a little bit here for my experiment. I might have to get some better wood. That little bit of stuff I put in there is not even all burnt yet, so might not need too much. Now it's got a cork on there, but it has a whistler, so it's already steaming. You can see it's already steaming. The water is probably already getting close to boiling, I imagine. Taking 2 minutes. It's already boiling. You can hear it. Close to 3 minutes. I better stand away in case that cork pops and steam comes out. You're supposed to take the cork off, I guess. But I wanted to see how the whistler works. So I decided to give that a try. See if it blows or what happens. They make a bigger, two bigger sizes, but I wanted the small one. You see how small it is. It'll fit in the backpack, just like a bigger than a water bottle, but definitely for backpacking, biking, and so forth. So, a little over 3 minutes. Went on 4 minutes. Definitely didn't use much wood. A few pieces of birch bark, a few little sticks. I hear something, I don't know if it's the fire or the water boiling that I'm hearing. Maybe both.
Maybe it needed a little more wood.
No, I don't think so. Happening is it's already boiling. Yep, boiling. See if it's gonna, yep, it whistles. It whistles. Lovely. So four minutes and 41 seconds.
For it to stop whistling, to start whistling.
That's not too bad. I sort of take this off of here. I have to use two hands, so that's end of experiment on film.